Troubleshooting. Excessive presence of refrigerant gas, oil slugging, and liquid slugging. We need safety helmet, safety goggles, safety gloves, safety shoes. Attention! Keep and read the instructions manual carefully and always respect the safety warnings indicated. Excessive presence of refrigerant gas in the oil. Effects of excessive presence of refrigerant gas in the oil. In the first case, we can see a seizure caused by poor lubrication generated by an excessive presence of refrigerant gas in the oil. If the refrigerant gas has excellent degreasing and washing properties, in this case, it washed the surfaces by removing the oil and placing itself between the cam and the connecting rod. As you can see, when the compressor started, since it did not have any lubrication, seizure was triggered and the connecting rods broke. We can see the purple color on the suction side of the valve plates. This is due to the massive passage of refrigerant gas from the suction side to the discharge side. The rapid thermal shock weakens the valves, causing them to break. Now, let's see a second case, which shows a strong seizure due to low lubrication. In this case, the greater presence of refrigerant gas in the oil caused more extensive damage than the previous one. In fact, it can be noted that the damage has led to the breakage of all connecting rods, breaking one near the seat of the piston pin, causing it to break. Also, in this case, it's possible to notice the excessive presence of liquid, thanks to the typical purple color on the valve plates. The purple color on the discharge valves also shows a higher quantity of refrigerant gas than in the previous case. How to avoid the excessive presence of refrigerant gas in the oil? In this case, we can see how the protective cap positioned in the housing of the crankcase heater, which Frascold places to protect the painting, is still present and was never removed. How to avoid damage to the mechanics caused by excessive presence of the refrigerant gas? We recommend using a crankcase heater. This improvement, used after a period of compressor standstill, minimizes the presence of the liquid refrigerant in the oil sump, and thus ensures suitable lubrication, which does not trigger seizure. Attention! The crankcase heater needs to be interfaced with the compressor contactor to prevent it from remaining powered during operation. Sprinkle the thermal paste evenly over the entire surface of the crankcase heater and insert it into the appropriate housing. This allows the resistance to dissipate heat evenly and guarantees the efficiency and durability of the heater. Oil slugging. How to know if an oil slugging has occurred? With a screwer, remove all the fixing screws of the compressor head. In this case, we can see how, once the central screw of the head is removed, there is oil both on the valve plate and in the head. To check the presence of the oil, remove the valve plate. Once the valve plate has been removed, we can see that in this case, the presence of oil is also abundant in the piston seat. One of the effects of an oil slugging. What is the effect of the oil slugging on the valve plate? Suction side. First, there's a deformation of the intake valves, which are normally completed closed. As you can see, a completely new valve plate does not present any deformation of the intake valves, which are perfectly tightened. Tip: Use a piece of paper and try to pass it under the suction valves. In the presence of intact suction valves, the paper cannot pass under them. If the paper passes underneath it, it means that the intake valves are deformed. Compression side. Tip: also in this case, it's possible to test the passages of the paper under the drain valves. If the drain valves are not deformed, the paper cannot pass under them. If the paper passes underneath it, it means the discharge valves are deformed. Alternatively, a torch can be used, placing it in the compression duct. If the light passes through, the discharge valves are deformed. Otherwise, if no light passes, the discharge valves are intact. How to avoid oil slugging? Frequently check the oil level, which must be no lower than 1/4 and no higher than 3/4 of the sight glass. If necessary, top up with oil as per instruction manual. Never top up large quantities of oil at once, but proceed with small charging steps. Check the operation of the oil line solenoids if equipped. Fit an oil level control or oil regulator. Liquid slugging. How to know if a liquid slugging has occurred? Liquid slugging has a very important effect on all compressor components, such as connecting rods, pistons, crankshaft, valve blades and cylinders. A connecting rod and piston assembly must be composed as follows. In this case, we can see how the connecting rods have shattered, even cutting the fixing screws of the lower part to the upper part of the connecting rod. The scratches present on the entire piston skirt are due to poor lubrication caused by liquid slugging. The coolant has in fact a great washing power, able to remove all the oil from the surfaces. This causes a strong seizure on the outside diameter of the piston and irreparable damage inside the cylinder. Please note how the segment, normally free in a piston, is glued in this case, becoming one with its seat. Incompressibility causes breaking and deformation of the intake valves. The debris from the broken valve is deposited inside the cylinder on the piston crown, creating an effect similar to hammering. In addition to the deformation, the breakage of the intake valves, the breakage and deformation of some compression valves is also caused. Tip: also in this case, it's possible to carry out the test of the passage of paper under both compression and suction valves. If the paper passes underneath, the valves are deformed. Another sign of liquid slugging is the typical purple color caused by the passages of liquid. Another effect of high presence of liquid can also be seen on the eccentric of the crankshaft. In fact, poor lubrication, in this case, creates friction between the connecting rod and the eccentric, causing a great seizure. Shiny, oil-free compressor liners and cylinders are another sign of liquid slugging. How to avoid liquid slugging? Check the correct operation of the system components, such as thermostats, solenoids, and valves. Perform scheduled maintenance on all system components and check their operation. Constantly check the working condition of the system and the compressor. If the system is equipped with liquid injection, monitor the correct operation and the settings for activating and deactivating the injection. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and discover all Frascold's video trainings. Frascold, blue is better.